I got into bartending a long time ago. I was vintage shopping one day and I came across a copy of William Boothby's Mixed Drinks. And I set out to make all the drinks in the book. My girlfriend at the time helped me build a bar in my basement. And so I spent about a year until my 21st birthday, like learning how to make all these classic drinks. I moved to New York City in around 2006. And I started working as a wine director at a restaurant. And my restaurant happened to be in between Death & Company and PDT. So I would go after my shift to these bars and I'd see what they were doing. This was the very first year that they'd opened. And I realized like, oh my God, they're doing what I read about in this book, you know, half a decade ago. And I decided to stop focusing on wine so much and I switched entirely to bartending. 2014, the Mandarin Oriental Tokyo contacted me and gave me this opportunity of learning a little bit about Japanese bar technique and then also teaching a little bit about New York style bartending technique. I learned so much living and working in Japan, most notably like omotenashi, which is the Japanese concept of hospitality. That really moved me. Working in an environment where there's like no tipping and you're doing hospitality just out of your love for it and learning a new appreciation for the craft and the tools. There are several things that are important to me when I'm choosing a bar tool. First and foremost for me is the functionality and how well it actually operates. Like if it's a bar spoon, for instance, the weight of it and how it's centered, like where the center of gravity is very important because it's going to dictate how beautifully and efficiently you can stir. Shakers are another example of that. The weight of the shaker and the feel of the shaker, how easily it comes apart. The weight of each of those pieces is crucially important. The feeling of a mixing glass is very important because you want to stir very silently. In the West, we're sort of generally taught to stir very quickly. In Japan, everything is done silently. I started using Japanese bar tools over a decade ago. They are far and away the most high quality bar tools made, and they are the most aesthetically beautiful ones. I've personally been using Yukiwa products for over a decade. To me, Yukiwa offers more stylistic choices. That speaks to me a lot, especially in environments like Uchu or Bar Moga, where we are building drinks in an individual manner. Having a gold set and a silver set and a rose gold set and an all black set, all these different sort of styles depending on the drink that you're making, because the shaker is sort of going to inform what the drink is going to wind up looking like. So Yukiwa allows me to have more different set pieces. There are a couple of Japanese ingredients that I'm trying to incorporate into drinks. Two of my favorite ones right now are kabosu. So kabosu is a great aromatic Japanese citrus. It has like the sort of tangy sweetness of a tangerine, but the aromatic properties of a lime and maybe a little bit of like yuzu thrown in there too. Another great example of that too is sudachi. So sudachi is this tiny little lime-like thing. I always tell people to think of like yuzu is to lemon as sudachi is to lime. There are a lot of differences between Japanese bar tools and Western bar tools. You know, 10 years ago, cocktail making was all about what was in the glass and just how good the product tasted. Now, the way that things have started to become different is the sort of presentation, whether that's the environment or that's the vessel that you're serving it in. But the tools themselves, I think, is a part of the process and it's a part of like the beauty of making cocktails. And Japanese bar tools far outdo the West in terms of that sort of aesthetic form follows function.